Welcome to Dasher, where we explore the vast expanses of the Marvel and DC universes. In today's video, we're going to discuss the children of Loki and ask the question, could we see them in the MCU? So, you may be wondering who exactly is the offspring of Loki. You may be surprised to learn that he actually had four sons and two daughters, those of which being Fenris Wolf, Midgard Serpent, Sleipnir, Vali Halfling, Hela, and Tess Black. Starting with the obvious, we have actually seen two of these characters in the MCU already, although with different origins. Those characters are Hela and Fenris Wolf, both appearing in Thor Ragnarok. But now that that's out of the way, what about the others? It's important to note that most of Loki's children are actually animals, those being Fenris Wolf, Midgard Serpent, and Sleipnir. And although they could always appear in the MCU, it would more than likely be a situation like Fenris Wolf, where they aren't Loki's children. So that leaves us with two, Vali and Tess Black. Starting off with Vali, we don't actually get to know his mom other than that she was a mortal woman. To keep his story short, he was caught stealing secrets and banished from Asgard by Odin and cursed with eternal adolescence by his own father Loki. Talk about a brutal grounding. Later, Vali created the Pantheon organizations to improve mankind, with his offsprings being higher up in the organizations. He mainly stayed hidden inside the Pantheon's headquarters, but every 50 years he would leave to recruit new members and procreate. Speaking of his kids, hardly any of them actually gained any godly powers like he has. But Vali actually cursed each of his kids to disintegrate to death, so that if he needed, he would be able to unleash their undead forms on his enemies. Now to list off some of his powers. He has superhuman strength, durability, magical abilities, training in hand-to-hand combat, and has the ability to teleport worldwide through technological or magical means. He also often carries guns with bullets that are capable of injuring invulnerable gods. With Vali out of the way, let's discuss Tess Black. Let me begin by saying Tess Black isn't all that interesting. Although she's a demigoddess, she doesn't actually gain any powers from being one like Vali did. And similarly to Vali, we don't even know who her mother is. One time though, she was actually possessed by the Sorceress of Chaos, otherwise known as Morwen. Morwen actually being a character in Spider-Man comics. Loki himself recruited Spider-Man to take out Morwen and banish her from Tess's body. So, now that we know a little bit about who the children of Loki are, let's discuss whether or not they can make their MCU debut. Like I said before, all of the animal offspring could very easily have appearances like Fenris did in Thor Ragnarok, but they more than likely wouldn't be Loki's children. Now, on to the two we discussed. These could very easily come into play now that Loki is getting his own Disney Plus series. And I could even see them doing a whole plotline in the show where he runs into his own kids on his adventures, either as a villain for him, like Vilas, or just someone to protect, like Tess. This could give Loki his own sense of purpose. We don't know for certain if Loki will have multiple seasons or not, or what exactly will happen, but it isn't far off to think that when traveling with the Deseract, he could end up sitting down and having a kid at some point. Whether or not it would be either Tess or Vali, though, is unsure. Personally, I believe that Morwen would be a great villain for Loki, like she was in the comics, and would even be a great way to have a crossover with another Marvel character to defeat her. But that's enough theorizing for today. So what are your thoughts? Do you think we could see these characters? How do you think the MCU adaptations would change them? Be sure to leave a comment letting us know. Thanks for watching.